A man once came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "Ya Rasulullah, 'allimni kalimatin a'ishu bihinna wa la tukthir 'alayya fa ansa." O the Messenger of Allah, teach me a few words that I can live by them throughout my life, but don't give me too much, lest I forget everything. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him just one small but very great thing. He said, "La taghdab." Control your anger. فَرَدَّدَ مِرَارًا The man asked again and again. He said, "Ya Rasulullah, give me something else. Tell me something more." The Prophet ﷺ each and every time replied with the same thing. لَا تَغْضَبْ Don't lose your temper. The man says, فَفَكَّرْتُ عَلَى مَا قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ فَإِذَا الْغَضَبُ يَجْمَعُ الشَّرَّ كُلَّهُ Rawah Ahmed. And this is an authentic hadith. He says, then later on I went and I thought about what the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said. And I realized that truly anger incorporates, or it is the root cause of all evils. And this really is true. Nowadays, sadly and unfortunately, we see that anger is so widely spread because of frustrations and insecurities and egos, that everybody is just ready to fight or curse or insult. But not just there. It truly is the root cause of, I strongly believe this, and as the Prophet ﷺ mentioned and the man says, it truly is the root cause of majority of our domestic, societal problems, evils, and crimes. Like Imam al-Baji rahimahullah, he mentions in his book Al-Muntaqa Sharh Al-Muwatta, he says, إِنَّ الْغَضَبَ يُفْسِدُ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الدِّينِ That verily or truly, undoubtedly, anger destroys majority of one's religion. فَإِنَّهُ يُؤَدِّي إِلَىٰ أَن يُؤْذِي وَيُؤْذَىٰ عَلَيْهِ Because it is the reason, the root cause that leads a person to harm others and get harmed by himself as well, by others, and harming himself. In anger, one harms his mind, his soul, and his body, and his health. And then he goes on and says, and while in the state of anger, a man or a woman says and does things that they regret later on, and they sin by doing it, and they make others sin as well, for which they will be responsible and they will take the sin as well. Because a man or woman in anger, they start saying things that are so evil that they make others angry. And those people who get angry, they start retaliating and saying and doing things haram as well. The sin of that person is also on you, because you were the one who led it to there and you were the one who caused it. And then he ends by saying that the one who has a temper problem or loses his temper, he also not just loses his deen, but loses a lot of benefits he could have got in this world as well. Because of his temper, his anger, people do not like to deal with him. He is not able to deal with people. Hence, he may be deprived of many promotions or jobs or many other benefits that he could have achieved or acquired if he was only a little calm. I was reading an article just a few days back where the author, who was a criminologist, mentions that almost the vast majority of crimes that take place, they take place within 20 seconds of the cause of the crime in the state of anger. Meaning it is the first 20 seconds after a cause is created that a person commits a crime, because they are still angry in those 20 seconds. In other words, trying to say that if one is able to control their temper just for those 20 seconds, he or she may just be able to come out of that problem successfully without causing more damage. There is a very great psychologist in the States, the United States, by the name Dr. Wayne, and a very well-known author as well. He says that an angry person can be compared to an insane person or a partially insane person. Why? Because just like an insane person who is not able to tell the difference between right and wrong, or their full brain is not working to its full capacity, similarly, a person angry and acting upon anger, his brain is not working to its full capacity. Rather, at that moment, he is only thinking about taking revenge or something of that sort, and he is not able to comprehend the situation, the whole situation, the whole scenario, or the consequences of his actions. Finally, I would like to end with the quote of Imam Ibn Hibban rahimahullah, which he mentions in his book Al-Awdat al-Uqala. He says, الغضب أو سرعة الغضب من شيم الحمقى كما أن تركه من زيل العقلاء. He says, the people who have a habit of losing their temper very quickly, this is the habit of foolish people. Not brave people or strong people, rather foolish people. Just like how controlling one's temper is the sign and the indication of an intelligent person. And then he goes on to say, he says, and anger is always the cause of disappointment later. And he says, finally, he ends by saying that, and the damage that could be fixed before getting angry or losing one's temper is much easier than fixing the damage that may be caused after losing one's temper. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from this evil, this act of ignorance and foolishness, from this touch of the devil. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.